Hello everyone, this is Emma Luma. So many of us usually have no idea about the full picture, the entire process of making a piece ready from the very beginning till the very end. We might have some blurry, vague feeling that we probably need to memorize the piece, playing with a good tone, making our own interpretation of music, playing technically effortlessly, and if we have a deadline for our performance, we will try to make the piece ready just by the time of our performance. In other words, we're starting a new piece quite blindly, without any clear idea about which step exactly we need to take along the road and how much time we should actually spend on each step. And as a result, practicing a piece stretches to unknown limits, and the last week before performance is just a hell due to the fact that the piece that we've been playing for ages is still not ready. So preparing a piece usually takes three steps: detailed analysis, deliberate learning, including efficient practice of difficult parts, and full rehearsing of the piece. And this gives us a good idea of the length of time blocks we should leave for each step. And usually the first analysis and the last rehearsing step are not even in the picture, and the middle learning step is usually a complete mess.
So this is a quick overview of inefficient and efficient ways of practicing. And if any of this looks familiar to you and you're interested to learn more, simply continue watching this video. And I will explain which way is inefficient to analyze, learn, practice challenging parts, and rehearse a piece, and which way would be much more efficient and safe.
So we all know how we usually practice. We start with sight reading, then keep playing the piece day after day, focusing our attention on some difficult fragments, bringing it to our teacher to get some comments regarding our interpretation, listening to some master pianist to get inspiration or maybe just copy their ideas. Or if you haven't done all of this, you can just apply all your knowledge about, correct tone production, phrasing, form, time. But we all also know that it might take sometimes months to finish the piece, and we wouldn't even be able to play it at our best. We would still have tension and stiffness in our hands, and our teacher would still give us some corrections. So I was thinking that you might want to know some alternative ways of practicing when everything is at ease, everything is effortless, because it's supposed to be this way. Playing piano has nothing to do with striving, struggling, or suffering. It has to be fun. We just need to know the rules that will let us play brilliant and at our best. So this way of practicing that I'm about to show you just in a second will let you finish any piece that you start from scratch within 1 or 2 weeks, playing with no technical limitations and freely express yourself through playing. And I have made this short time-lapse video, and the goal was to let you guys see and feel the whole process of practicing any piece by piano mode system. And I personally use only this method while learning any piece, and those pieces that are on my tutorials I learned exactly the same way because I just love it and it's very efficient. And I hope you can see how clear and easy and organized your piano practicing can be and should be and has to be this way. And it makes all the difference, guys, because you know, when you have this like deadline, when you have your exam date, and you don't have to worry about will you be able to finish the piece. You just know that even if you have 2 weeks, you have 3 weeks, you have 4 weeks, oh my god, that's a heaven, you will be able to play any piece that you just start confidently on the stage. I mean, that's all we dream about, right?
Marking fingerings and elbow movements in the score.
So I'm just trying to capture every fingering that comes to my mind in the first place. Don't overthink. And with elbow movements, I'm circling the notes that I would use to move my elbow to prepare a new position. Imagining every note in timbre with movement, playing while imagining using correct wrist and elbow movement. So this is the stage where I would make sure I can imagine every single note. That's why, as you can see, I'm starting with separate hands. First right hand imagine and play, and then left hand imagine and play, and then both hands. And when I'm playing, I'm really focusing only on imagination and correct wrist and elbow movement. Playing with intonation and weight, I'm just gathering the weight and playing while internally singing, and any articulation I would internally sing as well. Listening to harmonies, imagining notes and timbre in harmony with movement, playing with imagination and intonation. So this is the stage where I'm listening to harmonies, trying to catch and understand and feel emotional color of every harmony, so then I could imagine every note in timbre, violins and cellos in this emotional color of harmony. And again, when I'm playing, I'm imagining every note that I'm about to play. Imagining notes in timbre harmony and dynamics with movement and then playing. Imagining notes in timbre harmony dynamics and voicing with movement and playing. The same routine as usually, I would imagine first in the correct dynamics, so the little crescendo diminuendo. Make sure that I'm making all of this. And then with voicing, I would really try to first understand which melody to highlight, which note in interval and chorus to bring up. Imagining notes in sound texture with movement and then playing. And from this moment on, I would start using my pedal, because now the way I would imagine sound in this water texture would match with the sound that I would hear using my pedal. Playing with musical speech, I would play very, very slow, trying my best to feel emotional meaning of every single interval. Analyzing and marking full phrasing in the score, motifs, phrases, sentences, then playing with phrasing. So this is where you need to know how to exactly find motif, phrases and sentences. I do this now very quickly, and so again I express everything through intonation, through internal singing as well. Playing with emotional image, one of my favorite stages, where I just, you know, go to my look up, look down, so get super spiritual and emotional and just try to feel emotions through every single interval. Analyzing and marking musical form in the score, playing with phrasing, emotional image and form. Again, it takes some skills to find out where is the beginning of the piece, culmination part, rising to climax, you know, development, but eventually it's really necessarily. Playing with time. This is where I would try to find and feel emotional, how to say, time in emotional image, so it would reflect the emotion of music. Playing, expressing every musical mean of expression through artistry. This is the last stage where I would prepare myself to play confidently in front of the audience. Repeating a piece by small fragments to consolidate every musical meaning of expression, and memorizing a piece along the way. I might spend 2 or 3 days to do this, learning the piece by small fragments and bigger fragments, and eventually memorizing all the piece. That's it. And there are three reasons for that part of practicing. The first reason is to let all the tasks about imagination and singing kind of settle. So they will become small and solid in your mind, and that will be very easy for you to tune into them before you start playing and keep focusing on them while playing. Second reason is to let all the sensations and muscle movements go deeper in your subconscious, so you will have more room in your mind. In a way, your mind will be more clear and not so overwhelmed with all the tasks that you need to do while playing. And the last one is like a benefit. It will help you to memorize the piece solidly. I mean, by that time, the piece would be already kind of in your mind, partly, but not completely, not confidently. So by following that plan of learning, that solid memorization of the piece will come naturally. So I'm just saying that you wouldn't really focus on memorizing the piece, but by following that plan, you will memorize the piece. It's like a benefit for you. Now, the plan of practicing is very simple. You would take one small fragment, maybe 4-8 bars, let's say a sentence, and you would play it in different tempos from slow to fast, repeating in every tempo as many times as it takes to play and feel comfortable. Then you would need to make the same routine with every sentence in the piece, with every 2 sentences, with every 4 sentences, 8 sentences, and so on. Till you're able to play the whole piece. Easy. But we're all humans and we all have our own fears, doubts, and habits that would make this simple plan almost impossible to follow. So here are the tips for you to get through this plan successfully and hopefully finish the piece within a couple of days. So tip number one, be patient. That means that you need to accept the fact that out of 10 times, you're gonna play 9 times feeling complete disaster, feeling so uncomfortable, struggling with focusing on all the tasks that you need to make while playing. 9 times you would feel that your fingertips and your fingers feel nothing. 9 times you would feel that you cannot control anything, that everything is just falling apart. 9 times you would like know that you can never make it. 9 times you would really, really feel that something is really, really wrong with you. And then on the 10th time, all of a sudden, everything will become easier, more settled in your mind, in your muscle sensations. So you always need to remember that on this way of practicing, there's always this wave that goes down. So everything will get worse at some point, but then in the end, everything will get better. So you shouldn't stop at that low point. And it's like reading the book and then, you know, you would stop reading it somewhere in the middle where hero would start having some problems, some struggles with life. So if you stop there, you will never know that actually the end of the book, the hero was fine again. So sadly, we cannot skip any pages of our book of practicing. We just need to know that this is it, this is the process, you have to accept it, you have to go through this, and just be patient and have faith in a way.
What is wrong with me? I'm doing something wrong again. I will never play it as I want. Great, and now I feel it becomes even worse. Why is it so uncomfortable? Why my fingers are not moving? What is wrong? It will never work out. Okay, alright. I have to accept that 9 times I will not feel well while playing. Okay. That's hard and sad though, but well, that's the process and this is what it is, and I will keep repeating it with cold head and see what will happen. I will go through this. What is happening? Was it accidentally? What did I do? Can I repeat it again? What if I can't repeat it again? Oh my god, now I'm scared and I can't repeat it again. Okay, I'm gonna try again. Oh my god, it works! It feels so easy now! It's easy to play now! I can do it! I could make it! Yay!
And trust me, after some time, you won't have to go through this dialogue again because you will know that you can do it. And you will just keep practicing, keep repeating as many times as it takes, no matter what. Tip number two, be aware. That means you need to focus completely on the music you're playing while practicing. And if you feel and if you notice that at one point your mind starts wandering about the stuff that has nothing to do with music that you're playing, you should stop, you should gently correct yourself and start over again.
Oh, how others can do it? That girl from my class, she always could make it so easy. Her technique was so good. What if I could never be a good pianist? I'll practice and practice and practice all day long, and it's just so hopeless. Oh, my friend's party is tonight. Who's gonna come? Will he be there? Oh, I could wear that amazing black dress and to make that hair. Wait, what? Where am I? Oh God. I was completely out. How did that happen? Okay, focus, focus. Never mind. We'll try again. Alright, okay. Focus, focus, focus. And here we go.
And again, by practicing awareness, that will make one day so easy and so effortless for you to focus on music during the whole time of practicing. And the last tip, but not least at all, be cautious. That means that no matter how passionate and determined you are to go through this plan, to repeat non-stop, to reach your goal, to finish it finally, you have to be always cautious about your hand state, because this stage is very dangerous, as you repeat the same movements and that can cause unhealthy heavy tension in hands. And so if you continue ignoring this tension or don't want to like notice those tensions, that might lead to some injuries of your hands. So as soon as you feel that you start accumulating this heaviness in hands that prevents you from controlling of your tone, then you should really, really stop immediately, no matter how badly you want to continue. And I would suggest to make this breathing exercise where you would take, let's say, 10 inhales, and then with exhales, you would kind of exhale all tension in hands. It will cool your also hand a little bit. Then you can continue. Then if this exercise already doesn't help, then you should again stop, stand up, and make this small exercise that I'm gonna include in this video in a second, where you would bring blood to your hands and that blood would release any tension in your muscles.
Come on, I can do it, I can do it. Is it becoming harder and harder to play? Why? God, I'm scared now, something is wrong with my hands. Never mind, my hands can do it, it's just a fear. Oh no, my hands cannot do it. What is this feeling? Heaviness, weakness, and some aching? What is happening? Oh God, what if I get tendinitis or something? What if I can't do it ever now? Okay, wait. I just need to better treat and care for my hands. Nothing is wrong with me. It's just a part of this practicing. Let's breathe. Yes, I'll just give my hands some rest. Now gently try again. Oh, is it better? Thank God. Oh my God, it's better. Hands are lighter and stronger. Now it's so much easier to play. Wow.
So by taking care of your hands while practicing on this stage, you simply keep yourself away from any injuries and also from these very harmful thoughts that you might have injured your hands. That's it for today. I hope you had some fun watching this video and could relate to something that I showed you here. And always remember that we are making this stage very well. So at the end, we could forget about everything we've done. We could let go about any task that we need to follow in our mind. So we could completely focus on just emotional image, playing with open heart and express everything through artistry. This is another video for my students to help them correct three main mistakes that occur while speeding up: inaccuracy, unevenness, and tension. So, my dear students, when you notice any of these three mistakes, please don't expect that by just keep repeating the same fragment over and over again with no corrections, these mistakes will go away. It will only piss you off and let you just want to quit playing piano. So, five mistakes, know the reasons and causes of those mistakes, and correct those mistakes. That's a perfect plan, and that's what we're gonna talk about today. So, mistake number one, when your fingers are not playing evenly. Something like this. And you need to know that we control the even time between notes by better focusing on intonation and musical speech. What that means that first you need to really pay attention to which fingers exactly are playing faster. In my case, that would be second and third finger, or second and fourth. So as we know, we control fingers by our internal singing, by our intonation, and that means that we need to focus better on intoning the interval that leads to our third finger. And also, that might be very helpful if you pay more attention to musical speech in this particular interval, because emotional understanding of interval will only help you control your finger much, much better.
Why can't I play it evenly? So frustrating again. Oh, wait, maybe nothing is wrong with me. Just need to correct intonation and musical speech over here. Yes. This is ending third. Okay. Alright, that's better. Now let's see. Yes! Now it's better. Yes, it's good. Perfect.
Mistake number two. When your playing is not accurate, you keep missing the notes. Control the accuracy of fingers by better intonation, by better musical speech, just like in the previous mistake. So first you need to again pay attention to which finger exactly misses the note, and then control that finger with your internal singing by better intoning the interval that leads to that finger. For example, if I miss something like this, I would intonate better interval that leads to my third finger. Another thing that might help is just hold on for a second and imagine that particular fragment, that particular note in your mind again very clear. Because sometimes your finger keeps missing the note because your mind keeps missing the note in imagination, imagining something blurry instead of a clear sound.
Oh, this is so frustrating. Why did it keep happening again? I'll just keep playing, it will be fixed by itself. No! I keep missing notes. Alright, where is it exactly? Where is it? Okay. Okay, it's here. Alright. And I'll just imagine. Let's see. Okay, that's better. Australian. Yes! Now it works. Yes, now it's good.
And lastly, always remember that working out, at least in the period of time when you're practicing in fast tempos, will not only prevent you from injuries, but will also let you control your fingers and hands much better and play much more effortless. So this is one of my old videos with full workout routine.
This video is a part of inefficient versus efficient practice series. And previous two parts were about how to correctly analyze and learn a piece, and in this last part we're going to talk about how to practice at the last stage of practicing, when we have a week or so before our first performance. Again, if you're interested in how to exactly rehearse a piece, you can find it on my YouTube channel as well. So how do we usually feel in practice before upcoming performance? Well, in general, we would feel very insecure and anxious, especially if this is a new piece we never performed before and the upcoming performance is very important. We would easily get frustrated and panic if we don't feel any improvement after practicing, or sometimes it might get even worse the next day after practicing. There are always very annoying difficult sections in a piece that seem to be impossible to fix and scare us to death by just thinking about them, making us being afraid to play the whole piece. And because practicing in fear and anxiety affect our arm muscles, it all might get even worse when we start feeling aching pain in our hands or shoulders. And last but not least, fear, anxiety, and frustration affect our daily life as well, making us more tense, less secure about our piano skills, and even our life itself. That's why we need to have a simple system to practice at this stage. The whole system comes down to this simple practice. Play the whole piece non-stop, notice difficult sections, practice those sections afterwards. Repeat the same routine again. That could be 2 to 5 rounds a day. So today we're going to talk about how to correctly play the whole piece, how to efficiently practice difficult sections, and how to keep hands in the best possible shape. Now, if generally you feel not comfortable while playing, it's already another topic, and that's the reason I've created the PianoWell system and posted hundreds of hours of videos and programs that teach PianoWell system for free here in this channel. So for the sake of saving time in this video and focusing only on the current topic, let's keep this broad problem today. Let's quickly remind ourselves what exactly are those three stages of practicing a piece. At the first analyzing stage, we imagine notes, internally sang them while playing, aligned hand movements, analyzed phrasing and form of the music. At the second learning stage, we diligently repeated smaller and bigger sections in different tempos, getting all the pieces together, letting all the tasks from the first stage go to skills. So at the last rehearsing stage, after we have created the body of playing, it's time to breathe in the soul to that body. Start with taking a break from playing for a couple of days. That will cool down your head and let every task settle, become easier, smaller, and more solid. Just like muscles would actually grow on break days when we don't exercise them. When start playing again, bring in soul to your playing. Let go all the tasks from your mind, because it's already in the skeleton of the body, in the muscles and sensation memories. Focus only on inner world, on the energy in between notes, freely creating and improvising music you play. This way of playing makes all the difference. My video titled Pushing versus Pulling Playing shows the difference in playing with focusing only on executing all the tasks perfectly that pushes audience away, and playing with open heart with focusing only on free, creative energy that drags audience to our playing.
So playing with pushing feeling is when you really tune into what you need to do while playing. Like, I would think about, okay, I need to think about this and that. And this is how it would sound like. And I would try to make it everything like very accurately and properly. Which pulls the hearts of audience, we need to switch our attention to absolutely abstract feeling, something that is deep within you. I know all of you can understand. So, and basically, while playing, you simply speak out your heart. So let's just experiment and see the difference. And forget about everything. You see, my mind is still like, okay, tasks, tasks. Just erase it. Just erase it completely. Just pick out your heart. Changes the sound, how that changes the sound, how that changes how you feel while I'm playing. So yeah, guys, so let's talk about this right now. How to achieve this kind of playing.
So let's say we have played the whole piece and noticed some parts that are not comfortable to play or not played fast enough. This is how we need to efficiently practice them. Find out what exactly needs to be fixed. which lip or turn is not comfortable. Apply musical speech and position change. Repeat the section carefully, bring to original tempo, and practice the section in the context of a bigger section. If you're following the piano voice system, you have an idea of what musical speech and position change are about, and you know that you can apply both of them to ease any uncomfortable turns and leaps. Find out which interval needs to be felt more clear and start intonating it better with musical speech, moving elbow faster and with a bigger amplitude on a position change note. After fixing intonation movement in that interval, start repeating the section in different tempos from slow to fast. When you feel that you can now play it easy and freely, start playing from added sections. And you will find out that even if you manage to make the section itself, it's only half of the way, because playing it within the context of a bigger section would be felt absolutely different. So just keep repeating a bigger section in different tempos. And keep remember that complete result will be seen only the next day. Hands hygiene will not only prevent your hands from injuries, but will also ease your playing generally. Make a following routine, keeping in mind to have rest days to let muscles grow. And watch hands while practicing. Take breaks and make this relaxing exercise. For clear and precise sensations and fingertips while playing, watch for slipperiness of keys and fingertips, and drink enough of water.
Just take a segment of an orange and squeeze it. I'm not going to show it here, but you just squeeze it in your cloth, clean it, and then you wipe around the keys. Ta-ding. And after it's dry, after 5 seconds, that orange juice will create stickiness of your fingers and the keys, and that will solve our problem. And if for some reason you cannot make it at your teacher place, then I would definitely suggest you at least dip your fingertips into the meat of the segment, get juice, let it dry for like half a minute right before starting playing. That will help you as well. And for sure, if you are performing on the stage, I suggest you to make the same and to clean the keyboard, make it sticky right before you're playing. And moreover, you could even use the same cloth in the breaks between pieces. You know, like, ta-da, you know. And then put them back. Alright guys, another little hack to make your piano life easier is simply drinking enough water. Somehow it would bring more energy to fingertips. Of course, again, it will make it less dry and less slippery, but eventually it will create very clear and precise sensation on the tip of your finger while playing. It's so, so nice to feel while playing. 500 milligrams glasses of water, which by the way does not look as much as I would think it would look. This is 500 milligrams, I would never believe. Anyways, these 6 cups of water will make 3 liters of water for you to drink every day. And keep in mind that the effect from drinking water will be noticed only the next day. So the rule is easy, guys. You want to feel good tomorrow, take care of that today.
That's it for today. See you in my next video. Bye bye.